Welcome to another video presented by ATRA as part of the Virtual Training Solutions series. In this video, we're going to disassemble the gear train of the 845RE. So let's start by, and it, before I put it up on the bench, I highly recommend that you do not work on this thing laying down. And you're gonna see how fragile these parts are when I get them apart. So I would recommend always, always, always work on this thing standing up. So there we go. This is the, first we've got the, see if I can get it off. Oh, the P1 ring gear and the adjustment shim. This is the shim that we will use on final assembly that controls overall end clearance. So we'll just go ahead and set that aside. The inner race for the ring gear to planet bearing right here is built into the planet. As far as we know, if that bearing fails, you may have to, I haven't actually tried getting the, I don't want to bend it. It may pop out of there, but I don't want to bend it up right now, so be careful with that. Just set that aside. Now we've got the bearing that separates the planet. The cup faces down. This plastic washer on the P1 planet stays with the planet, so we don't have to worry about that. Now we're going to take the snap ring out. We're going to take the retaining snap ring out. I think you might be able to see it here. It holds the drum, holds all the gear train in. But first we want to use the special tools because this aluminum is very fragile. You may be able to get it out without breaking it, but I would highly recommend that you use the tools just so we use it for support, both for removing it and installing the snap ring. Okay, here we have some support tools. This ring is for the 845RE 8ZF8HP 4570. This is for the 80 and 90 model series. It's much larger. And these particular rings, aftermarket rings, were provided by our sponsor, Transtar. So let's go ahead and install this right here. You can see it's got a gap. So we're gonna set that gap 180 degrees away from the opening. It's a really tight fit here. There we go. There we go. Now we're gonna take our snap ring and remove the snap ring. Okay, so now I've got the snap ring out, and what I want you to notice here is that the shell will fall away. That's totally normal. So we're gonna continue taking our gear train apart here. So off comes the P1 planet. The P1 planet, there's a bearing down in there. We wanna make sure when we do our inspection to check that out. The P1, P2 sun gear. Notice the splines go up. There's a one end that doesn't have the splines all the way through, that goes down. This way, the splines face up. So that's the P1, P2 snap gear, sun gear. Next, let's see here. Going to pull the input shaft assembly out of the drum, and the D clutch, well, let's set that aside for the moment. That input shaft should come out of there by itself, but it didn't. But first let's look at what's left here inside the shell. So we reach down And out comes the D-clutch drum. This is the D-clutch drum, which is covered in the sub-assemblies video. Okay, so we can set that aside. Now with all the guts out of there, we could take a look at our, this is our P4 ring gear drive shell. All right, this is driven by this planetary gear set right here. That's what drives the P4 ring gear. So we could set that aside. You see it, it's real thin stuff. Now back over to here, we're going to, there we go. This, in this case, the shaft came out with the CE clutch retainer slash D hub. It all came up as an assembly. But when you do this, the input shaft may come up and out by itself, which is okay too. Either way, it doesn't matter. This is a magnetized ring right here. You could see how it moves from magnet to magnet. One of the speed sensors picks up off of that. So that's our input shaft. This is the P3 assembly, the P3 planet. And I believe, nope, that race doesn't come off of here. You want to take the planet off the shaft. For replacement, there's a snap ring right there that we're not going to cover that in this video, but you can take that snap ring apart and pull that planet off. Next is the P3 ring gear. P3 ring gear and the, or P2 planet. I gotta keep my planet straight. This is the two that just goes in order from top to bottom. P1, P2, P3, P2 ring gear, P3 sun gear, okay. This has a bearing in it, kind of an interesting looking hat bearing there. So we set that aside as well. So the P2 ring gear, P3 sun gear assembly, that also has a washer in it that is snapped in and won't leave the bearing. Yeah, see, if we have a destroyed bearing, that will come out, but for the sake of this video, we're not going to take it apart right now. So we'll set that aside. Now we've got our, this is the D clutch hub. Rides back here in the D clutches. And inside of that is the C and E clutch retainer, which we'll see here in a second. Now, once again, we've got another snap ring that we're going to need a support tool for. We're going to take a look at those support tools here in just a second. This support tool has been provided by Transtar that we're going to use to support this ring and get this snap ring out. Okay, so here we have our snap ring that's out, and why the support is so critical is because we're lifting it up this way, but you'll see the notches in the snap ring here. Those align with these rivets, here in the P3 planet. Okay, that keeps the snap ring from rotating. Okay, so we've got a bearing down in here. This is the P3 planet. This planet drives the D hub. All right, we've got a thrust washer, a bearing race that's built into the planet. So if that's worn out, we're going to change that out of here. We've got a bearing that comes out of the planet. There we go. We want to set that aside. So this is our P3 planet. Now, Up and out comes the DE clutch retainer. Let's just sit that over. And this is our D clutch hub. This is splines into this so that when the clutch is applied, these two are turning as one unit, which is driven by this planet. So that's how the planet, the D clutch is, this P4 planet, that's how the P4 planet is actually driven, okay? So we're gonna set that aside and come over here to our C and E clutch retainer. This is the P4 sun gear. This drives the part of the P4 planetary gear set. So let's just put that in through the hole in the bench here, pry the snap ring out. A little tricky because it's pretty far down in there. There we go. That's the top one. This is the P3 ring gear. Large space faces up. Then we have the bottom. So this is kind of interesting because there's a lot of stuff going on in here. There's three different methods to driving this gear. Okay, there's the ring gear. This is the first method. This is spline in here, so this can drive it. So the P3 planet not only can drive the hub, the D clutch hub through here, but it can drive the sun shell through here as well. So we've got a bearing resting on top of the E-clutch we want to take out. Now up and out comes the E-clutch pack. Now it's very critical, and I really like to zoom in on these splines right here. These splines are a very high wear item. So, and they will shear off. And so you need to really pay attention to these splines right here. Okay, so this is the E-clutch, which we will take a closer look at in the sub-assembly video. All right, now there is another, okay, so here we are looking down inside. So that was the E-clutch goes in on top. Now we have the C-clutch. We've got another small thrust bearing there. The cup side faces down towards the clutch. And then we're going to pick the drum up. This is the C-clutch hub, C-clutch drum, which we're going to, as I said, we're going to cover that in the sub-assembly, okay? Let's go back to the E-clutch here for a second. So this E-clutch is splined to the sun gear. That's the second method of driving the P4 shell. The third and final method is through the C-clutch drum, which is splined to the input shaft. So when the C-clutch is applied, the P4 sun gear is being driven at input shaft speed. So that's pretty cool. I like the way that's made there. So we've got one, the ring gear, two, the E-clutch, and three, the C-clutch, which is going to drive the sun gear at three different speeds. That's all part of what gets this eight-speed combination out of these four planetary gear sets. So finally, down inside here, we have our last thrust bearing. And that's all there is to the P4 Sun Gear drive shell. And that concludes the disassembly of the 845 RE 8-speed gear train.